Just for tonight, okay?
No, that's it. And I tell you what, I promise we won't wear out your bed springs for you.
All right, Trap, just hurry it along.
Yes, Mrs. Powell.
I'll be right outside.
Oh, Phil, it's so good to see you. They wouldn't let me last night.
Bad time?
Terrible. Those women, they're mad, Phil. And the warders are no better. Oh, you've got to get me out of here.
Of course.
Logan's trying to frame me for murder. I'm not going to jail for that.
You won't have to.
No? Oh, he's sitting pretty. And his brother-in-law is so high up in the police force, I won't stand a chance. I'm going to tell the police exactly why I wanted the money.
You can't.
I have to.
Now, listen.
Listen, if they understand how much I was to get out of this deal, they'll see that I had no reason to burn the factory down.
Barbara, calm down. Now, just calm down. Now, that business deal is worth a lot of money to us both.
I know that.
Now, if you talk about it before it's clinched, we've had it. The owner won't sell if he knows his land value is going to shoot up.
My getting out of here is more important than that.
Of course. But if we're careful, we can have both. Now, you sit tight until the deal's gone through. Then I'll have you out of here and Logan charged.
Yes, but by that time, Logan will have got free. He'll have had so much time.
No, you're wrong. I'll have a private eye tail him and investigate his alibi.
I don't know.
He'll think he's in the clear, then get careless and slip up on something.
Oh, all right.
Good.
But at least get me out of here. I'm allowed bail.
Yeah, well, I'm your solicitor. I couldn't put it up.
You mean your wife might find out about us?
Yeah.
Oh, all right. We do have to be careful.
It'll all work out. Trust me?
Yes. But please don't make it too long. You don't know what this place does to people.
Please, Chrissy, this place is getting bloody dangerous. I've just been attacked.
Oh, where is he? I could do with a bit myself.
The Sheila they brought in yesterday. She's off her head.
That one that wrestled the freak?
Yeah.
She was in the pound.
Yeah. Well, I opened the spy hole to have a look.
Yeah? And what'd she say?
I don't know. I thought I was a screw and she thumped me. I tell you, she's not the full quid.
Well, looks like she's got a bloody temper then, eh?
Where's Frankie Doyle and Murray Winter put together?
Yeah? Wonder what Bee's gonna do when she meets her.
Yeah. Oh, I reckon I'm lucky to still be here. She's got more muscles than the freak.
It's bloody interesting, that is.
What do you mean?
Well, she don't like screws, does she? Maybe Ferguson's gonna get hers at last.
Good day.
Oh, hello.
Came in yesterday, didn't you?
Yes.
Thought so. I was in the welcoming committee outside.
Oh.
Yeah, that mate of yours is a pretty tough bird, isn't she?
Sorry?
The girl in the van with you.
I've never seen her before. She's no friend of mine.
Oh. Know her name, do you?
No. Mine's Barbara. Barbara Fields.
Fields? Yeah, you're not that bitch that shot Doreen, are you?
What?
Yeah, that's right. I remember now. Doreen Burns, you set her up.
No, that's not true.
That's not what we
heard. You've got it all wrong.
Oh, like hell we have.
Someone set me up. They tried to blame Doreen at first, but that didn't work.
Pull the other one, love. Look, Doreen's got mates in here, you know. Good mates, like Bee Smith. Who?
B. Smith, the top dog. You know, the muscle around here.
Muscle?
Yeah. She don't like leggers. She don't like dobbers, neither. But why am I telling you all this? You'll find out soon enough. You sure you don't know that Besher's name you came in with?
No.
Oh, it's a pity. You're gonna need someone like her when B. Smith finds out you're in here. For protection, you know?
Where are you going?
Well, I'm off to the council again.
What for?
Try and hurry them up on the boarding house license.
For this dump?
Where else? It's all got to be legal, you know.
Yeah. You want me to come with you?
I thought you were going job hunting today.
Oh, it's happening in this morning's paper, although I've got an appointment for the one I saw last night, but that's not till this afternoon.
Oh. Well, come with me.
Yeah, then I thought I'd go and see Lizzie if they let me in.
Yes, I must do that soon. Give her my love, won't you?
Yep.
Well, let's go.
Any bricky going?
The maid's on strike. You'll have to get it yourself, won't you?
No, no, no.
Good
night. Good morning.
Get me a bricky, will you?
Yeah, sure.
There's an ashtray. Why don't you use it?
Geez, my neck's flaming sore. Bloody lumpy mattress you got there.
You could always ask for your money back.
This isn't a hotel, you know. You're lucky to be here. Now, the least you can do is to use the ashtray and stop with the wisecracks.
Oh, Judy, he didn't mean
it. I don't care what he meant. This is a halfway house for women. I don't think any women are going to want to come here if they find it looking like a pigsty.
Yeah. Sorry, Jude.
Well, I'll talk to you later.
Take you anywhere.
Ah, touchy chicks.
They're okay. You'll get us thrown out, but...
Who cares? I'm ringing the boys. See what's up.
We ought to do something.
You can start by getting my breakfast.
No. I mean... We ought to show Jude that we're not bludgers. Maybe I'll open the shop. Try and get rid of some of these bloody things for her.
Who'd bloody buy them?
Yeah. But there's got to be some suckers around, somewhere.
G'day, Bob. It's back.
Hey, Oles!
What are you doing here?
You have to help me.
Why, what's wrong?
It's the women. I seem to have done something to upset them. I've tried talking to them, but they seem to have made up their minds.
Who was it?
I don't know. She wouldn't give her name. But she threatened me with someone called Smith.
Yes, that sounds like the normal welcoming speech. Look, don't worry about it. You'll get used to it. I know it wasn't easy coming in with someone like Lawson, but thank God they're not all like that.
Look, you don't understand. I'm scared.
Yes, all right. But just give yourself a chance to meet some of the others.
I know.
Of the quieter ones. Make a few friends.
I don't want to. I want to go back to that solitary block.
Well, you can't stay there all day.
Oh, please.
I think you'd be better off keeping yourself busy doing something.
Like what?
Some work. Kitchen duties, that might help you.
Will the other women be there?
Yes, of course they will.
No!
You will be quite safe. There's an officer on duty all the time and a civilian cook.
Oh, all right. When do I start?
Now. Come on, help me with the lunch tray duty.
Ah, I think that's all.
Oh, crikey.
I've already filled most of these in.
Not quite. We've changed the system. There are 7 new clauses now.
Oh, that tells us.
You will have to make public notice of your intentions.
I've already done that.
And satisfy the health and fire department regulations.
Yes, of course, I'm willing
to... A council inspector will want to see the property to make sure any alterations you make are under regulations.
Right. Well, thank you very much.
Just a minute.
Oh, I can't have forgotten anything.
The soft toys, will they be made on the premises?
Oh, well, some of them might be.
In that case, each worker will require a minimum space of 30 square metres.
30 metres?
Yes.
Hey, what if I hired midgets?
And as for liquor, it may be consumed there, but not sold.
Right.
Well, anything else?
I